A whirlwind week of diplomacy continued today as the president of France, Emmanuel Macron, visited the capital of Ukraine following a lengthy day with Vladimir Putin. As Nick Schifrin tells us, war in Europe hangs in the balance. But the question remains, is there a path away from a fight over Ukraine?
On the second leg of a one-man diplomatic tour, French President Emmanuel Macron received a warm welcome today from Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky. And in a joint press conference, Macron said there was still time for diplomacy.
Our desire for the following weeks and months is for the situation to stabilize and for us to be able to re-engage a sustainable de-escalation.
But on the Ukrainian border, Russia continues to escalate and today deployed more ships toward Ukraine's southern coast. Zelensky demanded that Russia send its troops back to barracks, but also said Ukraine wanted to talk.
The first steps are what Emmanuel mentioned. We have a platform, the Normandy format.
The Normandy format was born in 2014, Ukraine and Russia in the same room with Germany and France. They negotiated the Minsk agreements, which called for a ceasefire in Donetsk and Luhansk, the breakaway regions in eastern Ukraine backed by Russia, and find a political solution. The Minsk agreements require both sides to remove heavy weapons, Russia return control of the international border that separatists control, and Ukraine's parliament to allow Donetsk and Luhansk, quote, self-government, and reform the constitution to allow, quote, decentralization. Today, Macron called Minsk the best way forward.
The Minsk Accords are also the best protection of the territorial integrity of Ukraine. Based on the commitment of the two sides, Russian and Ukrainian, we now have the possibility of advancing negotiations.
And yesterday, Putin said Ukraine had no option but to accept Minsk's demands using crude language.
Like it or not, you have to suck it up.
But Russia has never removed its weapons or given up its control of the border. And Ukraine's foreign minister, Dmytro Kuleba, today said handing over autonomy was dead on arrival.
I have repeatedly said we are open for dialogue, but we won't cross our red lines, and no one will make us cross them.
Macron says he's not trying to make Ukraine do anything, but he's long cultivated a relationship with Putin. In 5 years, the two have met dozens of times, including in Versailles, the historic home of French kings. And in 2019, he hosted the only meeting between Zelensky and Putin alongside then-German Chancellor Angela Merkel. Last month, Macron, who is running for re-election, said the EU should hold its own talks with Russia rather than rely on U.S.-Russia talks to defuse the crisis.
For both us and Russia, for the security of our continent, which is indivisible, we need that dialogue. We have to, as Europeans, lay out our own demands and put ourselves in a position where we can make sure they're respected.
Whether Russia intends to de-escalate and respect demands for diplomacy will be tested again Thursday when the Normandy format meets in Berlin. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Nick Schifrin.